All right, guys, Fulo coming to you with another video. Shout outs to the whole LDBC. So if you like this video, please feel free to uplike the video. And if you want to subscribe to the page, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. But if you don't want to, it's okay. It's always by choice, never by force. But Before I do this video, I just want to first and foremost give you guys the wishes that I hope you guys are doing okay in these times that we're living in. And I hope that in this situation that you have somehow managed to find a opportunity through it, or have managed to, grow in such a way that it's actually that this is a blessing in disguise for you guys. So anyhow, I just kind of wanted to talk about the whole Instagram live that Eddie Hearn did with Jermall Charlo. Now, I uploaded it, but I guess I uploaded it wrong, and the background beat kind of drowned out my voice as it was brought in to my attention. And so what I want to say is that I think in that Instagram live conversation, I think that honestly Eddie Hearn was just kicking the shit. I don't think Eddie Hearn really was serious about offering Jermall Charlo those fights. You know, he mentioned the likes of Triple G. He mentioned the likes of Canelo. And I don't even know why he would even mention Canelo when he has nothing to do with Canelo. When all Canelo is Oscar. Now, I know that they're on bad terms right now. However, it doesn't change the fact that he's on Golden Boy Promotions, that doesn't change anything. So what I'm saying is that why would you even mention Canelo's name if you're not prepared to, if you have nothing to do with Canelo, but anyhow, he was talking about a potential fight with, of course, we're always talking about this all the time, most of the time, is that, the back and forth with him and Boo Boo Andrade, there's different contrasting stories about this. I try to be transparent as possible. Although that Boo Boo Andrade, I'm going to support him, because we're from the same turf. So, of course, I'm going to go with someone from the same turf. Now, the thing is this about Eddie Hearn, and then I'll get to Jermall Charlo as well. But the thing is about Eddie Hearn is, instead of offering Jermall Charlo those fights, you should be trying to secure those fights for Demetrius Andrade. I mean, it would make sense, right? He is on your promotional stable, so why wouldn't you try to secure those fights for him? That makes no sense for you not to try to get those fights, whether it be a Triple G, whether it be a Canelo, or whether it be a Billy Joe Saunders, or whether it be a Daniel Jacobs, maybe even. But I don't know if I think actually the Daniel Jacobs fight can continue because I think Jacobs separated from his trainer, Andre Rozier, so they can actually fight and there won't be anything protruding that fight at all. Now, the thing is that instead of offering Jermall Charlo those fights, offer Demetrius Boo Boo Andrade those fights. so he won't have to be fighting his mandatory all the time, and he won't be criticized for fighting the mandatory, you know, because there's a lot of criticism with him fighting the mandos of the WBO, you know. Many criticisms have gone out to him in doing this, you know. But I mean, it's either that or be inactive, you know, at this present time. Now, I want to talk about Jermall Charlo. So, in the last two videos, Jermall Charlo, when he said, I forgot. It was on one video, but I think it was with him, and he was like talking about pull up to Wilder Fury fight and this, that, and the other, and he'll choose an opponent. And I think he said call Al, you know what I mean? And in this video, he said call Al as well, you know. And I gotta really give a shout out to Al Haymon for what he was doing in boxing before the whole pandemic happened. You know, he does great things for boxing, and just definitely a shout out to him and Sam Watson. And the thing is about Al Haymon is that since he isn't a promoter and he's an advisor, I think it would be like, it would make sense for the Demetrius Andrade and the Jermall Charlo fight to take place, for the simple fact that, you know, I don't think that Al Haymon really has anything to do with pushing for these fights. And the reason that is that I'm just going off of what they're saying. I'm not going off of what it is, actually. I'm just going off of what the fighters are saying. Now, Jermall Charlo has said he's his own boss, but he also says call Al Haymon, right? So I just give him the benefit of the doubt that he's in a partnership, and that partnership, fights in that partnership, are contingent upon if Al gives the okay for that fight. You know what I mean? That's what I'm going to assume. But there was an interview a while back. I think it was a couple of months back before we had this happen, this whole pandemic, where Jermall Charlo said, you know, I would fight Demetrius Andrade, Southpaw, Chinny. Tell DAZN Eddie to come holler at me. So if it was the case that they had to holler at Al, why not say that back then? You know what I mean? And I'm not going to say that they did send him an offer. I'm not going to say that they didn't send him an offer. I'm just going to say, why not say call Al back then? You know, when you said you were, you know, and you, when you said call me, when they were inquiring about the zone, you know what I mean? So in the word of words, I think it was just both of them kicking shit at the end of the day, you know. And from the looks of it, when we get off of this craziness, Jermall Charlo will be facing Eubanks Jr. and Demetrius Bubba Andrade. It looks like he's going to be facing, I think his name is Liam something. I think it's like Liam Williams or something like that. A UK guy who is the WBO mandatory. And at the end of that fight, I think he should maybe pursue a fight with Dervinchenko. You know, because he seems like one of the other only lone dogs in the middleweight division. And you saw what he did at Triple G. So I think that a few people aren't really keen on fighting him. So that would be a good fight for Demetrius Andrade to take. And the fight can happen because of the simple fact that it's, he fought DAZN on it. I mean, he fought Triple G on DAZN. So that fight can happen. But anyhow, man, leave your thoughts and leave your comments about this conversation they had with one another on the Instagram Live. Fula signing out. Enjoy, Rama.